Hi, everybody. My name is Oscar Rojas. I'm a PhD student at the Stein Monogastric Nutrition Laboratory, and today I have the pleasure to talk about the concentration of digestible and metabolizable energy and digestibility of amino acids in chicken meal, poultry byproduct meal, Ultrapro, ABE digest, and conventional soybean meal fed to weanling pigs. This is the outline of my presentation for today. I will start with a brief introduction explaining how is the production of each of the test ingredients that we use for these two experiments, and then I will move on to the digestibility experiments. The first experiment, energy digestibility, and then the second experiment, amino acid digestibility, and then I will finish my presentation with some overall conclusions. In this slide, we can see how is the production of chicken meal and poultry byproduct meal. We have on the left a chicken, and during the production to obtain the carcass, there are some leftovers that don't belong to the carcass. Those products are skin, flesh, and bones. And these products are the main components of chicken meal. But on the other hand, there are other components also that doesn't belong to the carcass. Those are feet, legs, beaks, and intestine content. And when those components are combined with skin, flesh, and bones, we obtain poultry byproduct meal. In the case of Ultrapro, this is a non-commercial experimental ingredient. And basically, this is prepared by enzymatic hydrolysis of pig intestines that were obtained at the slaughter facility. Now let's see how is the production of ABE digest. The process begins by blending spent hens with egg albumins and some enzymes. And this process goes for certain amount of time and temperature. The hydrolyzed mixture of these components are mixed again with a dry carrier that in this case is soybean meal. And then this is extruded and ground for a specific particle size. In this slide, we can see the chemical composition of each of the test ingredients. We have in the y-axis the concentration in percentage, and we have in the x-axis each of the test ingredients: chicken meal, poultry byproduct meal, Ultrapro, ABE digest, and soybean meal. The orange bar represents dry matter, and the blue bar represents crude protein. In the case of dry matter, we observe that it is quite similar across all of the test ingredients. But in the case of crude protein, we observe that in the animal protein sources, such as chicken meal, poultry byproduct meal, Ultrapro, and ABE digest, is relatively high compared with soybean meal. In this slide, we can see the concentration of ash, acid hydrolysis ether extract, and lysine concentration. We observe that the concentration of ash is relatively high in the animal protein sources compared with soybean meal. When we look at the acid hydrolysis ether extract, it's also higher in the animal protein sources, chicken meal, poultry byproduct meal, Ultrapro, and ABE digest, comparing with soybean meal, which is 2.1%. And in the case of lysine, it's relatively similar across all the test ingredients. So the objectives for these two experiments are to determine the concentration of DE and ME and the standardized ileal digestibility of crude protein and amino acids in chicken meal, poultry byproduct meal, Ultrapro, and ABE digest. So let's move on to the first experiment, energy digestibility. For this experiment, we used 48 barrels with initial barrel weight of 14.6 kilograms. We had 6 treatments and 8 pigs per treatment. And feces and urine samples were collected after 5 days of adaptation period. In this slide, we can see the ingredient composition of the experimental diets. As I mentioned before, we formulate 6 diets. The first diet was considered a corn basal diet, and then for the follow 5 diets, we mix the corn basal diet with each of the test ingredients. So in the second diet, we have the chicken meal diet, and it was a corn basal diet plus chicken meal. The third diet, the poultry byproduct meal diet. Fourth diet, the Ultrapro diet. Fifth diet, ABE digest. And sixth diet, soybean meal diet. For the statistical analysis, we analyze the data using the proteomics procedure of SAS, the fixed effect was the diet, and the random effect was the peak and the replicate. Now let's move on into the results. Here we can see the digestibility of gross energy. We have in the y-axis the apparent total tract digestibility in percentage, and we have in the x-axis each of the test ingredients. We observed here that there were no differences among test ingredients, and this indicates that the energy that is contained in each of the test ingredients is well digested for the peaks. Here we are looking at the digestible energy in dry matter basis. We have in the y-axis kilocalories per kilogram of dry matter, and we have in the x-axis each of the test ingredients. We observe that the digestible energy in dry matter basis was greater in poultry byproduct meal compared with corn, chicken meal, ABA digest, and soybean meal. And we also observe that the concentration of digestible energy was not different in Ultrapro compared with ABA digest, soybean meal. In the case of metabolizable energy, also in dry matter basis, we observe the same pattern as we observe for the digestible energy. It was greater in poultry byproduct meal compared with corn, chicken meal, ABA digest, and soybean meal. And the fact that these values for DE and ME in these ingredients are slightly greater or not different than in soybean meal, this indicates that dietary energy concentration will not be compromised if chicken meal, poultry byproduct meal, Ultra Pro, and ABA digest are used in diets fed to pigs. So the conclusion for this first experiment is that the ME concentration is greater in poultry byproduct meal than in chicken meal and ABA digest, and the ME in chicken meal is less than in Ultra Pro and ABA digest, but not different from that in soybean meal. Now let's move on to the second experiment, amino acid digestibility. For this experiment, we used 12 barrels with initial barrel weight of 12.4 kilograms. We had 6 diets, and ileal digesta were collected for 8 hours on day 6 and day 7 of each period, and each period contains 7 days. The first 5 days were considered the adaptation period. The design of this experiment was a Latin square, repeated 6 by 6, with 6 periods and 6 diets. Here we can see the ingredient composition of the experimental diet. We have 6 diets. The first diet was a soybean meal diet, and then we used the soybean meal diet mixed with each of the test ingredients, chicken meal, poultry byproduct meal, Ultra Pro, and ABA digest. And the last diet was a nitrogen-free diet that was used to be able to calculate standardized ileal digestibility values. The statistical analysis for this experiment, we used the difference procedure to calculate apparent ileal digestibility and standardized ileal digestibility of amino acids and crude protein. The data were analyzed by ANOVA using the proteomics procedure of SAS. The fixed effect was the diet, and the random effect was the peak and the period. Let's move on into the results. Here we are looking at the SID of lysine percentage. We have in the y-axis the SID, and we have in the x-axis each of the test ingredients. Here we observe that the SID of lysine was greater in soybean meal compared with chicken meal, poultry byproduct meal, Ultra Pro, and ABA digest. And we believe that the reason of this observation is due to the high concentration of bones in those ingredients. And we know that bones contain high concentration of collagen. And this collagen may have contributed to reduce the SID of lysine and other amino acids in those animal protein sources compared with soybean meal. In the case of SID of methionine, we also observe the same pattern as the previous amino acid. The SID of methionine was greater in soybean meal comparing with chicken meal, poultry byproduct meal, Ultra Pro, and ABA digest. And for the case of the SID of threonine, we also observe that it was greater in soybean meal compared with chicken meal, poultry byproduct meal, Ultrapro, and ABE digest. We also observed that the SID of troponin was greater in ABE digest compared with chicken meal, poultry byproduct meal, and Ultrapro. And we believe that this is the result of the addition of soybean meal in ABE digest comparing with poultry byproduct meal. And that is why the SID of threonine in ABE digest is between the values of poultry byproduct meal and soybean meal. So the conclusion for this second experiment is that the SID of amino acids in soybean meal were greater than in all the animal proteins. However, amino acids in animal proteins are well digested by pigs. This indicates that these ingredients may be used as a source of digestible amino acids. I would like to acknowledge Nutraflow and XFE products for supporting this research. And with this, I would like to thank you for listening, and I hope you find this information interesting. And if you want to learn more about monogastric nutrition, you are more than welcome to visit our website.